Hello folks, this is Tania reporting to you on Saturday the 7th of May 2016 from Patio Village. Today we weren't too sure about going out, but I decided to go out to Zoomarine one last time because I wanted to go to it again one last time before I went back home, because we're going home next Tuesday. And the weather apparently is a bit of a disaster area. It's pouring rain, it's lashing, and it's very windy out. It's very, very bad. It's miserable. But we actually risked it and went out. We went out to Zoomarine, and for a short time we left here about 4 to 2 and stayed there for a short time. We managed to see birds of prey show, and we got a photograph taken some guy in a photo shop took a photo of the two of us kind of a souvenir photograph of us, and so we were able to take home, and we got a frame with it, and we got some pictures, merchandise photos of dolphins and birds and stuff to take home with us as well. We got a frame to go with the photograph. We got this kind of a souvenir photo to take home. It's kind of a memory, kind of a memento of our time at Zoomarine, to remember our time there, so we can look back at our memories and look back at the time we were there to visit. So it's kind of like, so we can look back and remember that time we were there. So we just got kind of a memento photograph taken. A guy took a photo of us, and so it was nice, and it had a Zoomarine logo background, Zoomarine background, and frame is lovely. It's got the Zoomarine logo and a few pictures all around it of all different animals featured in the park, like birds, dolphins, and stuff like that. That's lovely. So we went to the Birds of Prey show. We got a footage of it, especially for Liam's brother, Ushin, because he's mad into birds. He's fanatic of birds, mad into birds. So Liam took the footage of the bird show for Ushin. And we went for something to eat at one of the restaurants.
The draft was dreadful.
And
the wind was coming in.
The bird show, they said it wasn't closed, but it wasn't exactly fully enclosed. There was people in the audience wrapped up in towels because it was so cold. And there was people in shorts, believe it or not, wrapped up in towels. Mm. It was so cold, there's a lot of people there weren't even dressed for the weather. And this girl there in shorts, and she was really shivering, her legs were moving, she was shivering. There were people who weren't even dressed for the weather. They dressed for a summer day, like they dressed for the sun was out. It was absolutely freezing. It was no day for summer clothes like shorts or dresses, summer dresses or flip-flops or any of that sort of thing. People wrapped up in towels today. It was unbelievable. They said it was enclosed. They said the bird show was enclosed, like covered up, but it wasn't fully covered up. It was quite open. And there was another bird show at 5:30. Today as well, that Liam was keen on going to, but then I had a kind of second thought that hanging around waiting because it was too cold and I was bored. I was fed up and I just wanted to go home because I was too cold and it wasn't exactly a great day for hanging around. I would have hung around if it was a better day, better weather forecast, weather-wise. The weather wasn't really great to hang around, so we decided to go home early. So we're just in the door like 10 minutes ago, and it's now nearly 4 o'clock. We're only in the door now. We're just having a cup of tea. And Liam was thinking of going into the indoor pool, but I don't know really whether it's a good idea to go back outside because it's too cold. I don't know what he wants to do. What do you want to do? Do you want to go out or what?
What's his EastEnders?
He wants to go. He wants to watch Thursday's EastEnders, and he's going to download my soaps from last night. He wants to go to the indoor pool and do a few laps, but I don't know whether I'd fancy going out there in the cold.
I thought my own was fine.
I want to get footed. But I don't want particularly want to be left here on my own either, so did you leave that footage?
No, I don't think it's there. I'm going swimming, that's it.
I go on.
You're going out to a movie and that's it. You're going to enjoy it.
He's terrible. Come with you. He's terrible, folks, isn't he? What am I going to do with him? Would you please tell this guy?
The water is warm. It's warm water, you know. The cold air doesn't make any difference to the indoor pool.
You have to go outside to go to the pool. That's the problem.
It's still
going to get wet.
We're going to the pool. Was part of the show. And also with Algarve, the peregrine falcon was brilliant. It was trying to catch a meal, and the man was swinging around the rope, and you see him swooping in really fast, and almost doing it, you know, almost catching the meal, you know. And then he'd swoop again from the opposite side in very fast, and try and catch the meal. And eventually, the meal was doing too fast for him to really catch it properly. Then eventually, the man put the meal on the ground, and the falcon swooped it down and ate the meal. You know? And the owls are great. I've never seen a real owl. I don't think I've ever seen a real owl. I've seen them on TV, that's all. I think I've never seen a real owl in my life.
I have.
Have you?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I've ever seen one. They were great as well, you know?
I've seen a real owl in the middle. Mm-hmm.
Really?
No. And there was falcons there as well. There was a Baptist falcon, Harris falcon or something like that. It was called the fastest falcon in the world, apparently.
Fastest bird in the world, yeah.
Fastest bird in the world. Mm-hmm. And the thing, he was flying around. There was this guy flipping around food or something on the stick. And he had the idea that the falcon was flying around trying to catch this food.
He was trying to catch the food. So he swooped in many times, swooped in 8-10 times.
8-10 times trying to catch the food that the man was spinning around. And the speed of this bird was unbelievably fast. Very, very fast. Unbelievable. It was an incredible show, and I'm sure Oisin will enjoy it thoroughly, and he will enjoy this pleasure. I'll put it onto my YouTube page, and he will watch it with great pleasure, I'd say. And I'll download it for him as well, or email it to him as well, because he can watch it in his own privacy and whatever he wants, if he doesn't look at YouTube. So hopefully he will watch it on YouTube and join my other interviews, my other videos as well, and enjoy them. Hopefully. Would he be able to come to Portugal with this?
He
will. Oisin, would he be able to afford it any
point? No, he isn't.
Would he not?
Mm-hmm.
It's a shame he couldn't be able to afford to come to Portugal.
Mm-hmm.
Would we be able to treat anybody? I guess.
But see how it goes. Maybe not.
I'll have to bring your mum to Portugal maybe next year.
Okay.
You know, the apartment. You know, because it says that you can invite a guest.
It's your man talking yesterday.
It's part of the deal, the apartment at the hotel. You can bring a guest on along with you as part of the deal.
Uh-huh.
So you could. Well, don't you invite your mum along?
Maybe we'll see.
I'm sure your mum would enjoy it, wouldn't you? I say she's up for it, but your mum has been to Portugal.
Talk to Karen. I've been to Tania.
I know, has she ever been to Portugal?
She doesn't either. She's been to Spain though.
You're not too far from here.
No.
But anyway, folks, I think that's our diary for today, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. But as Liam says, he is adamant that he wants to go for a swim this afternoon. He's adamant, and he's not going.
I'm not adamant, I'm adamant. Adamant.
I'm a huge fan of that singer, by the way. I love Adam and the Ants. Mad at the Adam and the Ants, I love them. Anyway, I won't go into that, however. Yeah, he's adamant about going to swimming, so I might get some footage of him doing a few laps. So that will probably go on my YouTube page as well. So you enjoy that footage. I'll put that onto my YouTube page tomorrow. As diaries go, I'll talk to you again tomorrow and to tell you about my day, what our plans are for tomorrow, what we're doing tomorrow. Anyway, I'll talk to you tomorrow again, and tomorrow again, the day is the 7th, so I'll talk to you tomorrow, the 8th of May. Take care, and I'll speak to you then. I'll be looking forward to it, and talk to you then. Bye.